Again, today I am going to tackle lecture on probability and statistics and our chapter number 1, basic probability. We have already seen in our previous lecture how we find the total probability for with the help of dice or coin or in a bag contains a white ball, black ball or red balls. Okay, so this is again the example of the unbiased coin is tossed 3 times. What is the probability of obtaining 2 heads exactly? Okay, so here following situation, that means what? An unbiased coin is tossed 3 times and what is the probability of obtaining 2 heads exactly? Okay, so here the following situation happens when we tossed 3 coins or 1 coin is tossed 3 times. Both are correct. Okay. So here the following situation happens when an unbiased coin is tossed 3 times. Okay. So here the situation is that first tossing, second tossing, third tossing and sample coins and with the 2 heads exactly. Okay, so here first we write here if we have the in the 3 times, so first time we are getting head, second time head and third time head. Got it? So sample point is what? Head, head, head. Got it? Next one is the first time is head, second time is head and third time is tail. Okay, so sample point is what? Head, head, head. Got it? Third point is head, tail, head. Okay, so the combination that means sample point is what? Head, tail, head. Got it? Here we write here the process is what? Process is that an unbiased coin is tossed 3 times. Okay, so first condition is head, head, head. Second one is, for example, first time we are getting head, second one is tail and third one is head. Next one is the first time is head, second time is head and third time is tail. Fourth one is what? Fourth one is first time we are getting tail, for example. Second one is head and third one is head. So here the tail, head, head. This is the fourth condition. Fifth condition is what? Fifth condition is head, tail, tail. Very good. So here head, tail, tail. Next one is what? Next one is tail, tail, head. So next condition is T, tail, tail, head. Okay, so here we are making the combination because of one coin is tossed 3 times. So next one is the tail, tail, head, tail, tail, tail. For example, all these 3 times we are taking tail. So we write here tail, tail, tail. Okay. And the next one is what? Next one is tail, head, tail. Okay. Tail, head, tail. That means T, H, T. Okay, so this is total all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 possibility where a coin is tossed 3 times. Or we can say that 3 coins are tossed 1 time. Okay, so this is the combination of we are getting all 3 times we are getting it, 2 times head or 1 time tail, 2 times head, 2 times head, that means the sequence is what? One time head, second time tail and third time head. One time tail, second and third time head. One time head, second and third time tail. One time tail, second time tail and third time head. Second and first and second time tail, third time head. Next one is all 3 times you are getting tail. All first time tail, second time head and third time tail. Okay, so this is the sample coins for if a coin tossed 3 times. Okay, but a question is what? A question is the probability of obtaining 2 heads exactly. Okay, so first we consider what is the value we are considering our solution. So here the 3 heads, this is the note. Okay, here two heads, yes. Here two heads, yes. Here two heads, yes. Got it? But here one head, no. Here one head, no. Here nothing and here no. And here one head, no. Okay, so total possible favorable event for a coin toss three times and exactly two heads. So this is the first, second and third. These three conditions are possible for when a coin is tossed three times. So probability of obtaining two heads exactly. Got it? So here the total formula is what? The event A. A is equal to what? We consider A is equal to probability of obtaining two heads exactly. In case, if you are getting the at least two heads. For example, in this question, we are given in the at least two heads. That means what? In the at least two heads, that is three heads are also included. So, in this question, in this three heads, we write here yes. Got it? But here we write the exactly two heads. So exactly two heads we are getting three times. So here the probability of A is equal to what? Total favorable event. So total favorable event is 3. 1, 2, 3. And total possible outcomes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here we write the 8. Okay. So this is your final answer for one coin is tossed three times or three coins tossed one time. Okay, so this is a very interesting example for finding the exactly two heads. So this is some rules for finding the probability, that is probability chapter. First one is the additional rule for arbitrary events. Okay. So additional rule for arbitrary event, that means let capital S be a sample space and A and B be any two events in capital S. Then probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability A intersection B. This is very important formula. We can say that this is very important formula because of many questions depend on this type of the formula. And here we have already seen in the previous lecture, here union that means or, and the intersection that means and. Okay, so union that means or and intersection. Intersection that means and. Okay, so in the or we write the plus sign and in the intersection we consider the multiplication sign. Okay, so here the probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability A intersection B. Okay, next one is the for any three events. For any three events, that means A, B and C, so it can be true that probability of A union B union C is equal to, open this formula, if we have the two events, so we write here the probability of A plus probability of B minus probability A intersection B. Okay, but in case for any three events A, B and C, so it can be proved that P A union B union C is equal to probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C. First we write the all these three events. Okay, after that minus probability of A intersection B minus probability of B intersection C and minus probability of C intersection A. Okay, plus probability of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, next one is the mutually exclusive event. This is very important point, the mutually exclusive event. Sometimes in a question we are given in the events are mutually exclusive event. Okay, and sometimes we find the value of probability of A or B or C. Okay, A or B or C, that means A union B union C. So we write here the probability of A plus probability of B and probability of C. Don't be confused here, because of here we also write the A union B union C, and here we write the A union B union C. But this is the formula is PA plus PB plus PC minus PA intersection B minus PB intersection C minus P C intersection A and probability of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, but here three events are simply we are given in the three events. But in this form, we are given in the mutually exclusive event. So always be careful if in your question given in the events are mutually exclusive event. Okay, so always keep in mind if we use the union sign or sign. So P A union B union C is equal to P A plus P B plus P C. Okay, so here for example a question given in P A intersection B. That is, events are mutually exclusive event. But in a question we are given in the two events and we consider the sign is intersection sign or multiply sign. So P A intersection B is equal to P phi. Okay, and P phi, that means the P phi, the probability of phi is equal to 0. So these three formulas are very important for finding the different type of the question, for finding the probability. Okay, so I will continue this topic in our next lecture. Thank you for watching this video.